Hello, best cookies. How are you today? I hope you're doing fine at home with your parents. Alright, this day two, we have come to another day of studies, social studies, basic three. We are going to look at ways of preventing common illnesses, and our subtopic is symptoms and causes of some common illnesses. Remember last week we looked at this topic, ways of preventing common illnesses. We looked at the meaning of illness, looked at the meaning of common illness and some examples of common illnesses. So, symptoms and causes of common illnesses, specific objectives here. At the end of the lesson, I should be able to, one, mention at least five common illnesses, two, state the causes of those illnesses, and three, give the symptoms of those illnesses, the ones you've mentioned, right? So, we have general symptoms of common illnesses. All illnesses, for one to be ill, you start experiencing headache, you have body pain or weakness of the body, rise in body temperature. We also have fever, cough, and fatigue. Fatigue, you feel tired. You feel as if you are not strong, you feel dull. So all these are general symptoms of common illnesses. Is that okay? So we have symptoms and causes of common illnesses here. We have illness, we have symptom, and we have cause. Illness, symptom, and the cause. Number one, illness is headache. Headache, what are the symptoms of headache here? We have nausea. We have vomiting, dizziness, we have pain in the eye when looking into bright light, which is called photophobia. What are the causes of this headache? Headache, alcohol can cause headache, stress can cause headache, lack of sleep also causes what? Headache, skipped meals. If you skip your meals, that will also give you headache. Is that okay? Then number two, malaria. Malaria, we have the symptoms of malaria, which include pain in the muscle. We have fever, we have fatigue, vomiting, and we have shivering. Is that okay? What are the causes of this malaria? Malaria here, we have Plasmodium parasite, which is, we also have mosquito bites. That's what we know as mosquito bites. When we allow mosquito to bite us, you know that it will give us malaria. So this female Anopheles parasite, it gives malaria. Number three, cholera. Cholera here, what are the symptoms of cholera? We have severe diarrhea, that is frequent stooling, right? We have vomiting, we have shortage of blood and water. One last blood, the water dries fast in the body and becomes short. Then we have weakness of the veins and the general weakness of the body. We have loss of appetite. You don't feel like eating. Even when there's food, you feel you don't have the urge. There's no urge to eat the food. Then what are the causes of this cholera? Causes of this cholera include infected and dirty water, polluted environment. Those who live in polluted environment, especially where we dump refuse, we collect waste from homes and deposits. If it is around where people live, it can outbreak this cholera. That's why we always pack here. We are always told to pack these things, pack the refuse and deposit very far in the bushes or far from settled homes. Is that okay? We also have polluted environment, vegetable grown with water containing human waste. The water that contains human waste, sometimes people pass feces, waste in rivers or streams. If you fetch that water and use it to irrigate our vegetable, and when we get this vegetable and cook, it can easily give us cholera. Then we also have the food or drink sold by street vendors. We don't know the source of this food, we don't know the source of water used in preparing the food, and the water itself may not be clean, may not be pure. Is that okay? The water may be infected, and if we take it, it can easily give us cholera. Cholera is a dangerous disease or sickness, right? Number four here, we have typhoid. Typhoid, what are the symptoms? The symptoms here include headache, rashes, rise in body temperature, abdominal pain, and we have dry cough. They are the symptoms rather of typhoid. What are the causes of this typhoid? Dirty toilets, flies perching on food. If you allow flies to perch on your food, they will transmit this dirty bacteria on it, and that can cause typhoid. We have eating food with dirty and unwashed hands, contaminated dishes, your spoons, forks, plates. If they are contaminated, you can easily give typhoid. Then we have dysentery. Dysentery, what are the causes of dysentery here? We have worms. We have protozoa infection. Protozoa here is a parasitic organism, is a microscopic, right? We have poor sanitation. Poor sanitation, all these are causes of dysentery. Dysentery can make one to do what? To stool frequently with blood. That is bloody diarrhea. Is that okay? Then noisy stomach. You always hear stomach turning with noise. If you want to poo or you want to defecate, you hear as if one is tearing what? Rats. Isn't it? Then it is another symptom of dysentery. We also have watery stool. We have weakness of the body as well. So all these common symptoms, they can kill if proper treatment is not given. Is that okay? So we have to take proper medication. If you have any of them, you visit the doctor and you take proper medication. Alright, so for your assignment, you've learned, so you must have to do some work at home. You mentioned 5 general symptoms of common illnesses. 2, state 3 causes each of the following common illnesses. A, dysentery. B, malaria. C, typhoid. Dysentery, 3 causes. Malaria, 3 causes. Typhoid, 3 causes. That's what I meant. And while doing it, you must have to write clearly and indicate the number if you can't make a sentence. Because I discover most of you are not making sentence. Mention 5 general symptoms. You can say the 5 general symptoms of common illnesses are, then you state them. Or you number it. Some of you write homework, you submit without numbering, without doing even making any sentence. So take note of that. Bye for now. We love you.